Today I welcome you all to teach grammar, the basic grammar. Okay, so let us learn the English grammar. In grammar, mostly we have alphabets. Okay, now alphabets, how many alphabets do we have in English? We have 26 alphabets. Okay, and alphabets can also be called as letters. Okay, so we have 26 letters in English. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. So we have how many letters? We have 26 letters. According to the sound each letter has, the alphabets are divided into two groups. Okay, how many groups? Two groups. The first one is vowels. There are five special letters in the English alphabet. These are A, E, I, O, U. What are they? A, E, I, O, U. Now these letters are called as vowels. According to the sound they produce, okay, they are divided into these five. A, E, I, O, U. A, A, E, I, O, U. Okay, so now we will see vowels. Now when we are talking about words, like for example singular nouns. Singular nouns means, what are nouns? Nouns are name of a person, place or a thing. Name of a person like Ahmed, Geeta, okay, Sita, Muhammad, all these are name of person. Then we have place. Name of a place means America, okay, India, Bangalore, Karnataka, then Shivaji Nagar, all these are the name of places. And things, anything like a water bottle or a pen, pencil, all these are things. So nouns mean name of a person, place or a thing. Okay, now whenever there is a singular noun, before that we will add these vowels, and these are called as articles. Okay, articles means A, an. Now this A and an should be added before singular nouns. Okay. So next we will go to consonants. As you all know that we have five vowels. Now all the remaining letters or the remaining alphabet are consonants, like B, C, D, F, G, H, J, K, L, M, N, P, Q, R, S, T, V, W, X, Y, Z. So all these are known as consonants. Okay. The letters except vowels are called consonants. Count the vowels and consonants in each words. Now can you see this word here? What is this? The word animal. Okay, now in this we have consonants and vowels together. Okay, so here A is a vowel, then N is a consonant, I is again a vowel, M is a consonant, and A is vowel, then L is a consonant. So, in a word, we have all these vowels and consonants mixed together. Okay, so here we have already done it for you. Vowels, how many vowels are here in this word? There are three vowels, that is A, I and A again. And how many consonants are there? We have three, N, M and L. Okay, so in the same way, theater. Here we have three vowels and four consonants. Okay. As I said you before vowels, okay, a word which has a vowel in the beginning. Before that, we are going to write an. And the word which has a consonant in the beginning, before that we are going to write a. Okay, so a has to be written before a consonant, and an has to be written before a vowel. Did you understand? Yes. Now here, antelope. So it begins with a vowel. So you are going to write an antelope. That means there is one antelope. Then 1 rupee coin. Now a few words or a few letters are beginning with a vowel, but they sound like a consonant. Like for example, one. This O is sounding like V. That is V. Okay. So V comes under consonant. So here we are not going to write an 1 rupee coin. Instead, we are going to write a 1 rupee coin, because the sound of O here is sounding like V. Okay. Then here we have union leader. Okay. Now this U, this U is it is a vowel, but it sounds like U, Y-O-U. So there Y is a consonant. So we will write A instead of writing an. Okay. So if the, all this, we have to first look at the sound. We should listen to the sound, then we have to represent with A or an. Did you understand? Then here we have another one. European. Okay, here also it is beginning with a vowel, but we are writing here as A, because European, U, Y-O-U. Understood? So Y is a consonant. So we will write it as A. Okay? Yes. There are special words like this also. For example, R. Now here, this H is a consonant or a vowel. It is a consonant, but we represent it here before that as an. Okay. Why? Because R. Now here R, it is sounding like a R. A is a vowel. So the sound coming out is the sound of a vowel. So we are going to write here as an R. Did you get me? Okay, so you have to listen to the sound and then you have to write it as A or an. Yes, here MBA student. Now M comes under consonant, but here we have written it as an, because M it is saying as a M, MBA. So the sound is of a vowel. So we will write it as an MBA student. Here, I have said you before, a useful thing. Useful. Okay. So here again it comes A, because this U is Y-O-U and Y is a consonant. Did you get me? Okay. Look at these pictures, children. Okay. There are many pictures here. Now the first lady here, what profession does she have? It's of a teacher. So she is a teacher. So why are we saying it as a here? Because T is a consonant. So we are saying she is a teacher. He is an electrician. Okay. So E is a vowel. So we are representing as an. Okay. Electrician. Listen to the sound. Do not see the letter. Listen to the sound. Okay. Dash apple a day keeps the doctor away. Now here, what is it? A, the, an or I? What should we write before A? Apple. A. So, A is a vowel. So, we are going to write an. An apple a day keeps the doctor away. Mother bought dash dress for me. Mother bought dash dress for me. D. What is D here? Is it a vowel or a consonant? It is a consonant. So what should you write before D? It should be A. A dress. Mother bought a dress for me. So students, here far we have you have understood that what is vowels and what are consonants. Thank you.